Hello there everyone, this is Mark 3 and welcome back to Mech Warrior Online. And welcome back to the Hotfoot, a mech which I featured quite a while ago. I think it's been a couple of months since this little thing last appeared in the video. But anyway, the reason this is here because, as I mentioned in the video at the weekend, and there is pronunciation errors already. I think it's because I'm a bit bunged up right now. Anyway, as I mentioned in a previous video, I've been working on getting a catapult which runs around at about 90 kph. And this is the mech that does it. The Jester variant of the catapult. Now, why was I doing this? I was doing this because I thought, hey, I want to have some power and armor. I want to have a fast heavy mech because you don't see them very often. And so I started poking around in the storefront to see exactly what I could fit it onto, what would work, what might not. And of course, keeping an eye out for things I actually already had. So I was looking at things like the quick draw. That's a good one. It's pretty fast. It can mount a really big engine. I think the dragon? That was the other one? Yeah, the dragons can fit a really big engine as well. Though they are actually a bit on the heavy side, so that slows them down a bit. And then I noticed something curious, which is the catapults. Now, the catapults, they aren't exactly the fastest mechs. They mostly have 315 as their engine limit. But then I looked at the Jester, and I noticed this: the Jester actually has a 355. So it can almost mount the biggest possible engine in an energy-based catapult frame. So, hey, I've got a mech I can modify for speed, and I'm kind of interested in the result, actually. It's very surprising. At least it surprised me, anyway. I'm not used to moving fast since I play heavier mechs so much. But anyway, let's actually show you the loadout. Now, as you can see, mounting the 355 engine here has given me 88.5 top speed. This is without a speed tweak, so once I get speed tweak on this thing, this will push up over 90 quite easily. Probably about 92, I think. But the problem with the 355 is it is extremely heavy, since it's a big engine. So this entire build has had to strike some compromises to actually mount an engine of that size. The biggest of which is the fact that it's actually an XL engine. So if the side torsos go bang, this mech dies. Yeah. Sad but true. It's not all doom and gloom, though. It's got weight saving on the endosteel, and also, because of a surplus of slots, weight saving on the ferrofibrous as well, which is I think it mounts something like 10, 11 tons of armor, something like that. And that's ferrofibrous as well, so yeah, it's not short on protection, this thing. It's got plenty of armor. It also features two jump jets, which is the most this mech can take, and a total of 5, 6, 7 double heat sinks. So that's 17 heat sinks total, which gives it a respectable heat management as well. Primary armament is low slot, but high weight. So it's got a pair of large pulse lasers, one on each side torso. And right now I'm experimenting with having an ER large laser in the center torso, just to give it it's a little bit less pure brawling DPS, but it gives it the option to actually snipe and poke at targets at a longer distance if it needs to. And with how this mech maneuvers, it really does help to have that extended range ability, especially on most of the bigger maps. Armor maxed out on the torsos, of course, since, you know, if we lose the torso section, the entire mech dies. Maxed out on the legs as well, because if this thing slows down, it's an easy target and it dies. So yeah, a lot of things can result in dying. The arms, though, are only half armored because, well, they don't actually have anything in them, so they're effectively disposable throwaway sections. Let's go to column mode and show you what I mean. The arms don't have anything. In my previous build, they had small lasers only, so that was still not much. But right now, it's actually better for me if the arms get blown off completely, because they cut the torso section in half, really, once they've been blown off. So it's just this bit here for the enemies to shoot at, instead of this entire thing around there. So losing the arms is a good thing. Also, I think I should mention very quickly, is I could have had the jump jets down in the feet, but I've put them into the torsos to help pad them against crit-seeking weapons like machine guns and things. So when the armor inevitably fails, it's slightly less likely to immediately hit an engine section and knock the entire mech out. So a bit of extra survivability in there. And that's what I've done with this thing. This is the Jester. A sprinting mad mech, which dashes around the battlefield like a headless chicken, for the most part. Anyway, let's go and see if we can actually get some decent fights with this thing to try and show it off a little bit. Though now that I've said that, it's probably going to be really awful. I'm going to do really badly. Let's go and see.
This is Command. Eliminate all enemies, no matter the cost.
Sensors online. Weapons online. All systems nominal.
And here we go. Welcome to Crimson Straits. In skirmish, so basically shoot anything that moves which isn't marked as a target. Yeah. Here we go. Weapon grouping on this thing is really simple. I've got both large pulses on button 1, like that. Button 2 is the ER. And then I've got 3 and 4 just to fire the individual ones. Though actually, button 4 fires the right, button 3 fires the left. That's just how my controls are mapped, unfortunately. There's not much point, but being able to fire a single pulse laser when in a fight and when you're really hot can only be a good thing. Now, you probably notice I'm manoeuvring quite well in this thing. That's because I've noticed that 90 kph is normally territory for medium and light mechs, and even then, during testing, I've tended to outpace most medium mechs that I've come across, so this is definitely a very fast mech overall. And a very, very manoeuvrable one. Its jumping ability is not too good, since, you know, it's still a catapult, but it's going to get into here. Yep.
At 25%.
Yep. I don't normally play jump jets, though, but it's worth trying, I suppose. Now, I mentioned that this thing can run around like a headless chicken a lot of the time. And that is true, because it's so fast. It's a second-line fire support mech, obviously with the XL engine involved. I don't want to be trying to slug it out with mechs and getting heavy damage and all that. But I can so very easily reposition myself around the battlefield like I am now. I'm actually running out ahead of everyone. And so I can react very quickly to what happens and what the enemy decides to do. And then just bring my pulse lasers and things to bear. So, you know. Yeah, everyone's just chasing around, aren't they? That's... yeah. This is going well. The guys in E5 are going to get killed. I'll just pop back there and see if I can support a little bit. Because that area is getting dangerously under-defended. Yeah, someone else in my team has realised that as well. Though, if this area gets too badly affected, I can just, again, run the hell away since I'm so very fast. The question is, where are the enemy forces? I don't really know. I've just got to try and find them. I suspect they're going to come through the tunnel, actually, because all our mechs are on top. So we might get cut off here. Also, we're split in half, and the entire enemy team is probably mobbing. So that's going to be fun. Oh, yeah, there's someone over there. Yep. Oh. See? Yep.
Incoming.
But I'm repositioning really quickly to just get into cover.
Warning. Incoming.
Ah! Suckers! Yeah, this thing can maneuver pretty quick. So I just got knocked there and didn't really do much in return, so that's kind of bad. Fortunately, everyone's too clustered around here. I can't really do much. Oh! Ow! Heck! Oh, I think that was someone up on the cliff, wasn't it? Basically, the ER laser lets me just distract people more than anything else. And yeah, it looks like the enemy...
25% of the enemies are eliminated.
Oh, wow, already. The enemy forces just went in the tunnels, so... yeah. this is not very interesting fight, is it? Well, I don't think it is, because I'm not really shooting stuff. I don't want to try charging up there. I mean, I've already got a few dents in my armour, but still.
Warning, incoming missile.
From where? Oh, hello.
Target spotted.
Yeah, I'm not meant to be out in front. Like, at all. But it looks like the enemy got pincered pretty effectively, so, you know. Progress is being made. Was that something moving over there?
We're experiencing some losses. Don't get sloppy out there.
I know, we were in the lead, but now we're not. And I've not been able to do much. Come on, we can do this. I'm actually going to push in with the rest of these guys on that Marauder, since it seems to be with little support. And, yeah, like any fire support build, if the enemy gets distracted, that's when I can really do stuff.
We've lost half our
target
force.
Destroyed.
We can't lose any more soldiers.
Yeah, we're winning slightly, but we seem to have lost our total forces. I thought that happened a lot faster to be honest.
Need assistance!
Right arm, critical damage.
Oh no, my right arm. It's so important that I keep that. But yeah, I kind of... There we go. Yep, I'm making him regret poking out of that. Oh, ow. Oh no, my right arm again. They think my weapons are in my arms, they're not. But yeah, this is what I mean about the arms being such big targets. And so I don't mind losing them at all. Though I'm getting cut off here now. Yeah, I need to regroup with the rest of my team. So I'm going to do that since I can reposition myself so quickly.
Target acquired. Target destroyed.
We're winning a bit. Should I try keep trying to pin them down in this tunnel?
I guess.
Yep, there's only two left. Okay, I guess it's almost time to start pushing. Oh, jeez, that's a Kodiak. I thought I was dueling with a flipping Hunchback too, not a flipping Kodiak. Ugh. I do not want to go head-to-head with that.
Target acquired.
Yeah, you're going to die, mate.
Target destroyed.
Okay, that was not too bad. I was making a nuisance of myself quite a lot, but let's check the damage score. I don't think it was that high, to be quite honest. Maybe I should switch back to the large pulse laser. Yeah, damage 179. Not overly great, but I got 5 assists, so I was working. Yeah, not too bad. Not too bad. Maybe I should make the refit back to my pulse laser, though. Because the ER... This was really my first fight with the ER laser. And I wasn't liking it that much compared to just having treble pulse on tap. You know? So... Yeah. Yeah, let's do that. Let's refit this thing back down to having... Yeah, so having 3 large pulses to unify its combat range and all that good stuff. So, strip out one of the heat sinks, which drops its heat efficiency slightly. It also frees up some slots. The extra ton of armor was mostly, well, actually practically entirely gone onto the legs, since, you know, torso kind of vital. And I think, yeah, that was a bit on the arms as well. Since, you know, arms, throw away, not very important. There we go. Okay, strip out the large laser. Put in the large pulse. There we go. So yeah, I've lost a little bit of heat management. I've lost some armor. And I have gained treble large pulse laser. Which is also going to be just in group 2, so I can right click and fire that one immediately. Anyway, let's get back into the action.
Command coming in. Capture and hold
reactor
the resource point.
Online.
Stop any hostiles
sensors
to get in your
online.
Way.
Weapons online. All systems nominal.
And here we go. Conquest. Grim Plexus. Capture the points, though. This usually just descends into a brawl, so, you know, whatever. This is the treble large pulse version, as you saw me quickly refitting during the mech lab. This is what I've mostly been trying out with this fast catapult build, so I'm more familiar with it than the ER laser fitted one, which you saw in the previous match. The thing is, though, I've lost, like, a ton of protection, mostly from the legs. Come on, get your facts straight, man. Yeah, mostly from the legs. And I've also lost a little bit of heat management. As you saw, heat during the previous round wasn't an issue, but with three large pulse lasers and loss of a heat sink, this mech now can and will run a fair bit hotter. Especially if I'm in a brawl and firing off weaponry continuously. So that is something that I now have to watch out for. On the bright side, sorry, my voice is just cracking again.
On the
bright side, I am now a more dangerous target in close combat because I can fire all three lasers for 33 damage if they all hit precisely.
Kappa is under enemy control.
Only for 17% heat as well, so that's actually still pretty good heat-wise. I think they're all the way over there. Oh, and our entire force is moving that way, so I need to go and catch up. Luckily, as I mentioned, mech runs around like a headless chicken, so I can catch up pretty easily. So, yeah.
Target acquired.
There's a spider over there that I'm probably going to get killed. But I don't want to be wandering around by myself, making myself a big target. This mech's not great for that. Oh, the spider's running. Let's see if I can head it off slightly. Though I'll leave myself open in this direction. Slightly risky, this. But if I can land a hit on the spider.
Command confirming that we have possession of.
Yes, hello, spider. Oh, hello. There's a shadow cat over here as well. And I think an ally just shot me in the back, so, you know. Ow. Yep, this is a big fight. I don't want to be here. My rear arm is also incredibly thin, so running away, bad idea. Gotta use those discardable arms to survive. Though an ally is now facing them as well, so, you know. Double back and try to start fighting. But yeah, I mean, the armor is very thin on the back, so, you know. Like 8 points across the board, so it's really bad. Hello, Kodiak. Just keep on firing. Come on. Oh, yep, I think he spotted me. Yep, he definitely did. He didn't like those large pulse lasers. But yeah, he is actually getting mauled pretty badly. Oh, ow, where's that coming from? Ow. Oh, the entire enemy team's here, that's why. That figures.
Target destroyed. New target acquired.
Where's the rest of our team? Oh, they're flanking.
New target acquired.
Oops. Hello, Hunchback. I see you're running away. Okay, the entire enemy team's here.
New target acquired.
Yeah, the thing is, the three large pulse lasers, this makes this design extremely dangerous. So enemies don't tend to like it. So if they realise you're laying into them like this, they try to prioritise you a lot. Ow! Like that. There goes the arm. Then again, the arms are really big sitting quackers of targets, so you know. And unfortunately, that's just me and this other guy here, so... Yep, he's had the same idea I have. Time to regroup with the rest of our force, rather than being heroic and sacrificing ourselves. Keep it
up. Target destroyed.
The enemy is at 25%.
Oh, I'm not sure what he's doing. Oh well.
Target acquired.
I think the enemy's getting a bit distracted. So am I. I'm not entirely sure. Why do we have two guys at F3? What are they doing?
New target acquired.
700 meters, yeah, that's way outside my effective range. Hello, Shadowcat.
New
I did acquired. Something. Oh no, there's another one. Yeah, I'm going to be outmatched here if I stay. Yeah. But the thing is, you can't underestimate the power of the large pulses. Three of them is actually really, really dangerous, so... As long as I don't take too much fire, I am a nasty fighter.
Target acquired.
Ow. That was a PPC shot, and my right left torso is open now, so that's a risky place to be. Where's he gone? Oh, there he is. Ow. Okay, yep. He hit my arm. Not a problem. Oh, my ally in that direction got killed, so... This might be bad. Oh, jeez, no. This is really bad. How many enemies are there? There's only three of us left, and there's five, six of them? Yep, we're in trouble.
They have resource point gamma.
We are in serious trouble. I'm suspecting that PPC mech might be flanking if I don't spot him. Oh, Jesus, Daishi. Ow. Yeah, okay. Yeah, as you can see, hit my open torso. There was no arm left on that side. And immediately took my mech out. But 402 damage, so I was definitely dealing it out. Only one kill and three kill assists, so it was a lot more focused as well. Yeah, there's only two of us left, though. And ON-1? I don't recognise that mech. What is it? Orion, I guess, but... The Hunchback I recognise, but... Oh, the ON-whatever that is dead as well. So this Hunchback's the last survivor. This game is over because it's a 5-1. I'm not sure what happened there. I think... Most of our force got wiped out pretty early on, to be quite honest with you. I mean, that's what was happening. So, yeah, most of the force that went to capture that point got wiped out fairly quick. So I think that's what lost the match for us. We split up and then got kills. The entire enemy team was together pretty much. This Hunchback's trying though, bless his heart. He's trying, but there we go. He's dead. Okay. So in conclusion, this 90 km/h catapult is kind of fragile because of, you know, the XL engine and all that, but it can run around and deliver a lot of firepower. I think I prefer having three large pulses rather than having an ER large in the center torso, because more power rather than the flexibility, you don't really need the range because you're fast enough to move around and reposition as you like without any real trouble. So, yeah, I actually like this build a lot. And I'm definitely going to be playing more of this one in the future. 402 damage, 3 kill assists, 1 killing blow. That's not too bad. Could have done more, but I wasn't getting that many targets to shoot at. Well, let's have a look at the... Where am I? 402... Yeah, look at this. Most of my team did less. I was like the third highest damage dealer, so we lost too many early on. But yeah, this has been Iron Mark 3, taking a look at my 90 km/h catapult. I hope you enjoyed the show, and this build has given you some ideas or something like that, because I've realised of late that I don't tend to make standard builds that much. It's like I just fit things together as I like, and on a whim, I think is probably a better way to describe it. If I think it'll be fun to drive it, then that's what I tend to do to it. So, you know, I can come up with some odd stuff sometimes. So, yeah. I hope you enjoyed the show. Hang on, I've messed up my outro again. Hope you enjoyed the show, and I'll catch you some other time. Yeah. I'll see you later.